What's up, guys? It's JBeats here. And you read the title correct. I will be doing a fantasy draft with only QBs, meaning I'm going to be drafting 53 quarterbacks. I will then be using those 53 quarterbacks, moving around their positions, changing their positions, so that I have a team full of quarterbacks. This is obviously going to be a tough journey. However, I mean, that's what we're here for, baby. So now, let's get into the draft. Okay, 6th pick, that's pretty good. I don't think it really matters, though. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Obviously, you're going to have to take Russell Wilson, because obviously he is the X-Factor, and he's just very mobile. Don't know exactly where I'm going to play him. I might actually keep him at quarterback. See, again, I'm just going to search by development trait. Just go through. Pick players. Because honestly, especially doing an experiment like this, you just want your players improving as much as possible. And that's just going to be able to do that through X Factor, Superstar. So yeah, this is. If you don't think this is going to be difficult, then you're surely mistaken, because this is going to be probably one of the hardest things I've ever done on Madden. Purely just because of how bad some of the players are actually going to end up being. However, we are getting some good players, and there are a lot of quarterbacks that are pretty good athletes just to begin with, like Russell Wilson. And especially as we head more down towards the backup sort of category, there's a lot of players that they're very fast or very strong, and honestly, you just kind of need that, and then we can build up your skill through just them progressing and overall. At least the nice thing is, with me taking all these quarterbacks, if I can somehow injure another team starting quarterback, it's likely that they won't really have that good of a backup. I mean, go a little dirty, do a little New Orleans Saints action, but, you know, don't have to necessarily do that. I honestly feel pretty good about these first 10 picks, just because, I mean, you gotta take what you can get. So Cam Newton, I am very perplexed on where I want to put him, because, I mean, he is 6'5", 245 pounds. Oh, geez. He can play pretty much anywhere. I'm also trying to just kind of figure out in my head what kind of balance I want between offense and defense. Honestly, I think on offense, not really going to have that good of players playing offensive linemen, because that's just be a waste of players. But at the same time, I also don't want to have my quarterback having less than 2 seconds before he's at least destroyed by a defensive lineman. But you know, it's a learning curve. And definitely going to be playing the preseason, just so I can get a feel of the team and see what's going to work in the regular season. Honestly, I don't expect us to really win any games at the beginning. But I mean, again, you kind of expect that. Alright. Why is Hurts still available? Oh, they gave him normal? I thought he had hidden. One thing I am a little concerned about taking these quarter quarterbacks is their injury rating. Which I have no clue how quickly it's going to be until they're injured for the rest of the season. I mean, in a weird way, they might actually be good, just so we can get a different player in there. Gotta take Marcus Mariota. He's just too mobile. He's definitely going to be probably a wide receiver, if I were to guess. But, I mean, really the key in this at this point is really just taking speedy quarterbacks and strong quarterbacks. I mean, I don't really need to draft a quarterback I want to be starting a QB for, because, I mean, I already have all of them. And the other nice thing is, most of these backup quarterbacks that are still available, most of them are pretty much runners anyway. Like Brissett, Tyrod, Trubisky even, Marcus Mariota. All these players are young and are decently quick. mean, as far as QBs go. I mean, RG3, put him at slot receiver, most likely. But, I mean, I think this team's going to be very, very interesting. Jeez, I don't think there's anybody left yet. Oh, yeah, Tyree Jackson. And we're just kind of going for these athletes at this point. The only thing I am concerned about is the preseason. Once the starters go out, I think it's going to end up being really, really ugly. Just because, I mean, we're going to be having players like Blake Bortles and offensive linemen, most likely. So the biggest thing I'm totally struggling with is who do I put on offense, who do I put on defense. So I want to take some of these just kind of taller, bigger players now, just to kind of fill up those offensive and defensive linemen positions. But at the same time, I also have to make sure I take good enough just all-around athletes to play skill positions. Also, don't know what I'm doing with kicker and punter, if I'm even going to really care about them that much. And I think I'm going to get like two more just taller regular quarterbacks, and then I'm just going to take speed for the rest of it, or just size. I'm honestly really excited for this series. I think it'll be very interesting just to kind of see how everything ends up playing out. So, I mean, as you guys can imagine, this is already going to be insanely hard. Not even thinking about the fact. Oh, God, take the go, Tracy Curry. And Joe Webb. Those of you younger people, Joe Webb was one of the best backup quarterbacks in Madden history for the last couple of Maddens. Obviously he's quick, but for a year or two with the Bills, they put him at receiver a couple of times. And if you did that on Madden, there were so many trick plays that you could open up with the right playbooks. Honestly, I'm feeling pretty good about this team. I tried out the draft to just kind of see how things would work out before. I was able to get... Tom Brady instead of Drew Brees, but that was before they took Brees' X Factor away, so that's probably why Brady got picked up, because I wasn't going to have Brady just be like a tight end, just because of how slow he is. I think it's just going to be interesting to see what the other teams do about the quarterback situation. So, you know, I'm taking all these backup quarterbacks, in fact, I mean, preseason, who might actually have a chance on defense, because they might be pulling out a 45 overall quarterback. The Steelers are now on the clock. I was considering adding kickers and punters to this, mainly because I wanted to take Hack from the Dolphins, just because he is a physical specimen, with also having, I think he has star at least. Always considering adding him, just kind of the kickers and punters to the mix, purely because of him. Then I decided not to, because I also was a little concerned about how many quarterbacks I was actually going to be able to take. But after seeing how it played out, I realized, yeah, I had plenty of players I could take. I'm honestly so excited for this. It's gonna take a whole lot of time for me to kinda move all these players around, figure out which positions I'm gonna want them to be at, because obviously it's so crucial. Like, normally whenever you do a fantasy draft, it's just about, oh, who am I gonna start, what kind of team do I want? But I mean, with this, I'm purely responsible for building an entire team exactly the way I want, with not the greatest of players to have. I honestly expect this offense and defense, and the team's probably only going to be like a 20 overall if we're lucky. I think that just having like a probably Russell Wilson maybe at QB is just gonna save the team overall, because I mean that's a 97 overall right there. I mean, yeah, it's gonna be interesting. And this is nice that there is a lot of quarterbacks and they are very well rounded in their skill set, to the point where this actually isn't that boring, and I'm not just taking 60 overalls with 85 speed over and over again, to the point now where I'm taking these 6 foot plus quarterbacks with decent speed, but also at the same time having these really tall, strong quarterbacks that don't really move. Okay, I think now, yeah, I'm looking for these 6'3" and bigger scrambler model QBs, just because of size and speed. I mean, really, this one I'm just taking athletes. I think it would be pretty interesting, just for like an exhibition game. So I think one thing that Pro Bowl should do is, like on like a 7v7, is do something kind of like this, where they put all the players from one position in like teams and kind of sort of like a little mini bracket. I'm sure the players would love that. Obviously the numbers wouldn't work just because of who's selected to the Pro Bowl or not, but it'd just be cool to see if the NFL were to do something kind of in the off season like that, just kind of give us fans something really, really cool to watch. The Steelers are now that we're nearing the end of the draft, I'm very, very concerned just how the team's gonna do overall, but I do feel good about the players we've taken. Especially now, I mean, we're still getting these fresh out of college, fast, athletic quarterbacks, and we're in around 50 right now. I mean, it's going to be very, very interesting to see how everything ends up working out. So we really only got like 3 picks that actually matter. I'm just going to see what other stats I can search by. Just try to get some stronger quarterbacks right now. As we make our final selection, I just want to say, if you're still here, after I finish this draft, I'm going to call, stop recording, figure out the team, and then I'll be back and you guys can all see what the team ends up looking like. I'll probably end this video there and then probably just end up having the first gameplay video just be the first preseason game. I'll worry about that then. So I really hope you all have enjoyed watching so far. Stick around for probably another 10 seconds and you'll get to see what the team ends up looking like, what players are what. I'll go through the depth chart so you can see everything. And I'll be back in a minute. Alright guys, so I went through and I edited the team, and as you can already see, yeah, we're only an 18 overall. But now we're going to go through the depth chart and just kind of see how everything's looking. So I have decided to stick with Russell Wilson at QB, just because he was the only really good quarterback that I got that was both a mobile threat and a passing threat, as I feel like we'll definitely need our QB to scramble a whole lot throughout the series. I also have Easton as backup and Matt Barkley. So at halfback, Marcus Mariota is going to be our starting halfback. He's a 65 overall, with Easton Stick backing him up and Jordan Tamu. To be honest, I was contemplating putting Mariota at wide receiver, but once you see our wide receivers, you'll realize why I put him at halfback. So fullback, I put Paxton Lynch, just because he is the strongest quarterback that we drafted. So wide receivers, we have Tommy Stevens, Danny Etling, RG3, Quinton Flowers, Drew Brees, and Chad Kelly. Honestly, this is a pretty decent receiving core, very good speed, and as you can see catching here, their catching actually isn't that bad. I feel like we'll just have to work on their route running and all of that. But, I mean, catching is really the big thing, because with Russell Wilson, as long as you get the ball to the dude, That's all you really need to do. So tight end, definitely a position we're struggling at right now. We got Bryce Perkins, Jacoby Brissett, and JJ Barrett at tight end. Honestly, I really want to pick these dudes because they are bigger, faster, and stronger. Which is basic tight end. Don't know how much we'll actually end up using them. But, you know, hey, I have no clue what I'm about to do. So at left tackle, I have Kirk Cousins and Case Keenum. As you can see, they are similar overalls. I don't know. I want Cousins to get a good amount of XP. So next up at left guard, Matt Ryan is the starter. He's actually the only offensive lineman that's not 12 overall. And Josh Rosen is his backup. At center, got Tom Brady. Didn't really know where else to put him because, again, he is extremely slow. However, just put him in at center with that super... Because, I mean, X-Factor, but centers don't have X-Factor abilities on a superstar. So he is listed as superstar, but hopefully he can develop quickly. And Blake Bortles will be his backup. At right guard, I've got Phil Rivers. Again, big dude with star development. Doesn't really have much speed, didn't play anywhere else. And you've got Kyle Allen as a little bit more athletic option to back him up. Then I got Jimmy Garoppolo at right tackle with Matt Moore as his backup. Now once we get to the defense, it was very hit or miss as far as everything went. So Gardner Minshew is a 23 overall left end, and with star, he should be developing quickly. Then we have Nick Fitzgerald, the rookie, backing him up. At right end, Sam Darnold will be the starting right end for the team, with Joel Delagala backing him up. D-tackle is one of the positions that we missed at. However, we do have 6'7" Tyree Jackson starting at D-tackle, and Alex Smith will be his backup with Geno Smith also backing him up. So as the defensive line is not half bad. At left outside linebacker, I've gone with Jalen Hurts. He's just very well-rounded and athletic, and he's big enough. And Jeff Driskel will be backing him up. At middle linebacker, Cam Newton will be starting for us with Joe Webb as his backup, then Haskins and Slaughter. At right outside linebacker, we got the GOAT, the legend, Trace McSorley, with McGo backing him up. So in linebackers, we actually did... So looking at corner, Tyrod Taylor, I don't know why he's this high, but he is. And I got Trubisky backing him up with Huntley, Boyle, and DiNucci as my other corners. I feel like this group, it won't do that good, but I don't think they'll get beat deep because they are decently quick. At free safety, I got Teddy Bridgewater, Chris Streveler, and Taylor Heinicke. Bridgewater, honestly, did not expect him to be, you know, this good of a free safety. However, he does have the build and the speed. And I'm sure you're all wondering, where is Taysom Hill? Well, there he is. I decided to put him a strong safety just because defensively, that's where I think he'll make the biggest impact. That way he can, I mean, with my playbook, strong safeties end up blitzing a decent amount. Some of the 3-4 packages they play down. And just overall, just hopefully he gets superstar so we can give him some good abilities. But even if he doesn't, he's still in a good position to do well. And Cole McDonald will be his backup. At kicker, I have gone for Ben Roethlisberger, and he's actually a 67 overall kicker, which I feel like is really good. And Ryan Finley will be the punter. Now, just because Ben is a 67 overall, we do go over and look at the kick power. I mean, it's decent. Kick accuracy is decent for both of them. But again, I don't actually know how much I'll actually end up using them. So returning our kicks will be Quinton Flowers, our wide receiver, with DiNucci as the backup. Tyrod Taylor will also get some returns in preseason. Taysom Hill will be our punt returner, just because, I mean, he can do it all. Cole McDonald will be the backup punt returner. Ben will be our kickoff specialist. Tom Brady will be our long snapper, because again, we can get him as many snaps as possible so he grows. Third down back will be Marcus Mariota. The power back will be Easton Stick. And in the slot, I've decided to go for RG3. Just because I feel like, I mean, you gotta have RG3 on the field. At rush, left end, gonna go for Trace McSorley. Just trying, you know, want to get him on the field as much as possible because he's the legend. On the opposite side, I got Jalen Hurts. Again, rookie, just trying to do what he can do. And our rush tackle will be Sam Darnold. Just again, trying to get these younger guys out there. I really just went for overall these positions. Sub linebacker will be Cam Newton because he is, I think he's going to be a big key to our defense playing well. And Joe Webb will be the backup if Cam Newton goes down. In the slot corner, I've gone for Trubisky just because he is bigger. Hopefully he can body off some of the smaller receivers to get us a lucky pick. Because honestly, it's what we're looking for. So yeah, I mean, that's the team. I'm just getting a little better look at everything overall now. Definitely going to have a lot of runs with Russell Wilson and Marcus Mariota. I feel semi-confident about our receiving core. And our running back core is just, I'm very concerned about how our offensive line is going to end up doing. Defensively, I actually feel semi-confident out. I don't really expect this team to get many stops. I think it's just going to be a matter of, can we hold them to a field goal? I don't really expect it. I mean, we have pretty fast players. I don't expect us to get burnt over top. But, I mean, no one has a clue how this is going to end up. And special teams, I mean, if we absolutely have to, I feel semi-confident about using Big Ben to kick. I mean, you never know. I mean, that's not that good of a lineup. Hey, I mean, we're here. So if you have enjoyed this video, make sure you like and subscribe. I'm about to play the first preseason game, so if you want to see that video, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And I'll see you all later. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, theys and thens, peoples of all ages and species, the Super Bowl is the game. Next game we are about to play. This team of 53 quarterbacks, we are about to play in the Super Bowl. Not even just the playoffs, the Super Bowl. We drafted 53 quarterbacks. We converted their positions around. We went from Russell Wilson, from Drew Brees, to Tom Brady at quarterback. We've shifted the defense around. We've shifted offensive weapons around. We have grown Tommy Stevens from a 50 overall wide receiver, 53 I believe, to a 75 overall wide receiver. We have had Marcus Mariota get star. We have had our tight end Perkins catch for 1,000 yards this season. We have seen our team progress and grow as a unit together. And now it's all on the line. The biggest stage in the NFL, Super Bowl 55. The Pittsburgh Steelers, with Cam Newton, who's just on the screen, number 99, is a middle linebacker. We are facing the Joe Burrow-led Minnesota Vikings. I cannot stress to you how big this game is. This is the end of this series. This is potentially the end of the most strange season ever. We could walk out here as Super Bowl champions. Joe Burrow and the Minnesota Vikings. This, ladies and gentlemen, is what Madden is all about. Season number 101 of the NFL might have been the most unconventional yet. In Raymond James Stadium, we have advanced to the Super Bowl with whatever you want to call this team. Jacoby Brissett at defensive tackle. Sam Darnold and Gardner Minshew at defensive ends. We have a chance to defeat not only Joe Burrow, but to make sure that Ben Roethlisberger is the only rookie to win the Super Bowl. Alright, let's see the coin flip. We always want to go with the wind, and they always tend to want to receive. I know this is very predetermined down on what's going to happen. Second only to the Patriots 11, but if the Steelers win this one, then they'd be on top of the all-time win standings, as it would be their seventh title. Michael Thomas could be an issue today, but Tyrod Taylor, the cornerback, has a chance to stop him. And that's right, that is Big Ben Roethlisberger leading the special teams unit out onto the field, as he is going to be kicking off to whoever that loser is. Ladies and gentlemen, Welcome to Super Bowl 55. Let's go. Let's go. Not only during 2020, the craziest year, with the craziest world happening around us, the craziest team to ever make it. A team drafted with 53 quarterbacks. We have a chance to win the Super Bowl. Alright, let's see Joe Burrow's season stats. Pretty solid. You expect from a Super Bowl quarterback. However, he's just a stupid child. Alright, we're gonna go... I don't know how good this team is yet, so we're gonna go just a simple cover 4 drop. Alright, they're going spread first play. I can respect it, you know? Alright, I can also respect a nice defense. Alright. Let's go. Brissett did a good job of getting past his blocker there. We just gotta make sure we always go to the right. We don't want to get tangled up with Sheriff like we did right there. Alright. Good throw there. Alright, they're going to go a little bit of a... They're going to go strong look. So we're going to go 4-3. Nice 4-3, cover 2 man. Russell Wilson on Michael Thomas, Tyrod Taylor on Mecole Hardman. Alright, couple yards for the rush. Got the 2 big, Trace McSorley with the tackle. We're going to try this 4-3 look again, because I'm not 100% convinced they're actually passing here. I think this could be a run play. Alright, well, it's not. Alright. Good route by 17. Cole Hardman. Alright. So we're going to try this dime look now. We're going to go cover 3 blitz, but we're going to show 2. And we're going to guess pass. This is the same exact formation they started the game in. Alright. We're going to try cover 6 this time. No, no, we're going to stick with the play. Called it for a reason. It's a fake. Ooh, nice hit there. Can boil, yep. Okay, we're going to stick with that cover, too. Alright. Okay, give them. Alright. Now we're in a. This is blitzing territory. Now we're just going to go cover 2 man here. See if we can get McSorley working on this right tackle. Good stop there. Second goal. We're sticking with this open look. I think we're going to counter it with a nickel look. Because, you know, I don't trust them. I think they can run this here. Alright, well, it's not a run. It is a pass only for 2 yards. So, 3rd and goal. I assume they're going to try to power this in. So, we're going to blitz. And we got man coverage pretty much everywhere else. Alright. They scored early. It's okay. First drive of the game. They did have to take a little bit longer than I expected. Yeah, 4 minutes, 35 seconds. They were obviously in no rush to score. It's okay. Our strength is our offense. And now they have a chance to step onto the field. Yeah, wish fair catch this. Alright, Tom Brady. Let's see what we can do. We'll just start off with a nice simple run. Nope. We're gonna flip the run. There we go. Good truck there by Easton Stick. Nice 12-yard run to start the game off. Alright, now we're going to try double ins. You know, get the ball back in RG3's hands. You know, this is his first game in multiple weeks. Okay. I will admit I heard that. It's okay. Alright, we're going to try big play action play here. Stevens usually gets open on this route. He isn't. Well, I don't know what he is, because Tommy Stevens is always open. First down. I'm going to try this bubbles play. Look, RG3 underneath, actually. Alright, good job by Brady there, still getting that throw off, because I didn't realize how many people were actually pressuring Brady after he threw the ball. Alright, we're going to try that same play action play, just in a slightly different look, because they are running a little bit of a press coverage here. And that works in our favor, because Tommy Stevens has got the surest hands I've ever seen in my life. Alright, now we're going to do a draw play to Mariota. That was a bad decision. Actually got one or two yards. Did they blitz on that play? Yeah, that was a blitz. So they knew that we were doing that. Alright. Alright, that's the end of the first. Darn, alright. We'll hit Stevens for a touchdown here. No problem. Aww. I didn't think he was covered. Oh, that's third down. That's not good. Alright, we're going to try. Hopefully, they stick with man coverage. Everyone clears out so Perkins can catch and run here. That's a first. Rolled for the first. Thank you, Mike Hilton, for that bad tackle. Alright, we're going to go inside zone with Mariota. Nope. We're going to look Steven on this play action play. Alright, good throw there to Etling. We're on the 6. Alright, I'm going to try to see if Mariota can catch the defense lacking here. Should be on, it's on. Touchdown, Marcus Mariota. Just like pending the extra point, tied 7-7. This is very stressful. I mean, anyone who knows, the Super Bowl, it's the biggest game. Anyone else watching that makes Madden YouTube videos, you understand. Because it's one thing if you lose, but it's one thing if you put out there that you lost in the Super Bowl. And, you know, you'd be like, losing, be like, oh, yeah, man, you know, I made it to the Super Bowl, but, you know, I just got unlucky with your friends. But when you make it to the Super Bowl and you're putting it out on the internet, you're basically showing yourself, hey, I lost the Super Bowl. It's pretty tough. I have done it before. In fact, a couple of my fantasy drafts, I have not even made it out of the first round of the playoffs. But that's not going to be today. Nope. We're having no embarrassing moments. We're making it. Oh, Jalen Hurts got hurt. It's ironic, but annoying. Alright, we're going to try what got us here in the first place, where defense mainly used to do. A little cross-middle linebacker blitz. Don't ask me why, but it just actually seemed to work pretty well for this team. Is that Driscoll? Yeah, it was Driscoll. Hurts' replacement got a nice, pretty decent tackle there. But we're going to stick with this middle linebacker cross-blitz. Even though they're throwing it. Oh, why couldn't any of you catch that? I mean, we literally had them. dislocated shoulder. He's out for the game. Okay, that is not good. Well, Driscoll's had limited playing time this season. Let's go. Good stop there. Alright, we're gonna go punt safe, man. Because even if we try to return it, our return men usually don't get back there. O'Donnell's the one to punt. He's not that great of a punter. Alright, that's good. Alright, we're on the 20-yard line. Alright, Brady, let's see what you can do here. Okay, Reed is that outside middle linebacker. Yeah, but he came on the blitz, so that throw was open. Probably could have waited a little bit longer to hold that, but I mean, we still got 9 yards out of it. Now we're going to hand this off to Mariota. Run for the first. Mariota all season long. He doesn't get those. He doesn't really get those big chunks of yards. He gets those 3 yards that we need. Alright, we're going to look RG3, actually. No, stick is wide open. Juke him. Eh, decent juke. 4 yards. Take it. And that was Patrick Chung. Now we're going to look to go a spread look. And just look to hit RG3 underneath. Alright, that's what? Second and two? Third and two? Let's show faith in our run. Alright, so it's an overload blitz on the left. So I think we're still going to run to the left. Yep, for the first. Yeah. Got to show not only their team, but also our team that we're not afraid to run. We will run the ball if we have to. Alright, this ball is looking to go to Stevens. Yeah. Good defense by that 29. That had to have been a blitz, right? Yep. Actually, no. I saw what I wanted. Play action, Bucks cross. This play works really well if it's zone, because Stevens can just... Steven ends up usually just running underneath a bunch of zones, but that's not what it was. We're going to try to air it out deep to Etling, but again, good defense. All right. Slot post. Hopefully Perkins. This looks like it is a cover, too. Can get in behind those middle linebackers. All right, it's not. So it's fake cover, too. Oh, I did not see him. Mariota got in the way. I couldn't see him. What are you doing? He's just standing over top of him. That could potentially lose us the game. Man. Just like that, they're in field goal range. They're probably going to score. Not good, it's not good. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have this is not good at all. Oh, you're joking. Cam Newton was literally standing right there. He was literally standing right there. You saw him, he just stood there. It was the ball running right by him. That should have been an interception. Alright, well, we need to score a touchdown before half. Otherwise, this game could... We could be in a very bad spot.
Turn on sports media. He's okay. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
The Steelers take over first and 10.
All right, game's not over. I see. I would love to be a lot further than we are right now.
A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out. Now sounds
like things. Good throw to RG3 there. Did he go out? Yes, he did. All right. Now we're on their 43. Gonna run a flood play. This is man to man. From like RG3 underneath, but I think it's zone. Stay down, Tommy. There you go. No. Okay, one of their players just got hurt. Wait, that's their star D tackle. Aw, what a shame. So I think this is actually a blitz. So RG3 should end up getting open. No! You're joking! No! I swear that was man coverage. Could have sworn that was man coverage. Oh great, now we have to, we're in a big hole right now. Are they just not even going to try? I mean, I'm okay with that. I'm okay if it's going in a half and only got a touchdown. I got concerned. I thought they were going to... They're really going to try to score. Incomplete. Oh, okay, thank goodness. All right. Cannot press right now. Have to drop off. Thought they would go a quick play there, just try to get the first. All right, he caught that. Yep, they're going to try now. Let's get this cover for a drop. I'll pick that off. And you're going to try to take this in the half? Like, what's the move here, Vikings? That's twice now that Joe Webb. Alright, so there's 9 seconds left. I think they're probably just going to throw a screen pass of some sort. Just to flag. What's the flag? I'm going to decline it so the clock runs out. Or not. Why wouldn't the clock run out? I declined the penalty. Okay. Alright, that's not the...
That's the end of the first half.
Not the way we wanted to head into halftime.
14. Steelers 7.
Alright. They just got more interceptions. I mean, realistically, we should be winning. Because we've stopped them. They've just been really lucky. Yeah, we're just going to fair catch this one. Alright, well, I mean, it's still very early in the game. I could tell myself that. I'm stressed. I don't like where we are. It's like none of our downfield passes have been working just about all season long. They just stopped working today.
It's now 2nd and 10 at the 25-yard line. I'm going to follow right along with you because
the spot they're in now. Like, I don't know where it was. Like, beginning of the season, all throughout the season. I mean, even last game, we were firing in all cylinders. I don't know what happened. Oh, you're joking. Alright. We're gonna go for it, because... I mean, our punts only go so far. Now we're gonna go plain old spread. Double slants. As long as we make the right read here, this is a first down. Alright, good job, Aggie 3 there. Alright. Sometimes you gotta play really risky. Sometimes it'll pay off. Thankfully, that time it paid off. Don't know how lucky we'll be next time, but we can worry about that next time. The pass interference?
Brady's pass intended for number 23. Incomplete. It's 2nd down and 10. First down leads to a 2nd and 10.
Throwing again. Brady. All right, spin it forward for 6 yards, I believe. So 3rd and 3.
That's a gain of 7. Brings up 3rd and 3. A 2nd down
completion got him 7. I don't think Flowers will get open. I think it's going to end up going to Stevens. On play action, now Brady. It's going to be a holding. I think they'll accept it. They declined it. All right, so we got 4th and 3. This is going to RG3 the entire way. I'm not looking at anyone else. There we go. All right, now we throw underneath to Flowers. Nope, that link. Oh my God. It was there too. That was the throw. Come on, RG3. All right, good. 11-yard line.
First and 10 at the 11-yard line. What the receiver's trying to do is make
the defender think he's going up field. Now we're going to look. Just stick. Hopefully stick him. Find himself open. Oh, jeez. No. No, that was not a fumble. That was not a fumble. No. They're just gonna spread it out and dot us up. Good job there, Driscoll. What are they doing in the red zone that our previous opponents have not been doing? Because we haven't been able to do anything in the red zone this game. But, you know, in our last game against the Patriots, we could do anything we wanted to on offense. Oh, I missed. Get there, Taysom.
Vikings first down. Big play for the first and 10 at the 31-yard line. 52
yards. So how about this? This is not looking good. From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. Now a 10th carry for Melvin Gordon. And he's got this down almost to the. You can't stop the run.
Melvin Gordon. First down. 10 more yards. That's another Vikings first down. First and 10 at the 21.
We need a turnover. Realistically, that's the only way we stay in this game.
Gordon again, the ball carrier. Taken down at the 19-yard line.
The only way we win this game is a turnover.
Brings up second and 8.
On second down, they'll run it, Gordon. All right, good job, Jacoby. This is still 3rd and 4. 35. Gus pass. It doesn't really matter what we do. They're still going to get it. He didn't get it, though. They got to kick it. Yeah, they're going for it. Yeah, this is the play of the game. We're going to get run, commit, run, committal. How? Literally how? We ran commit up the middle. That was already a nickel blitz. There's literally no way. How?
After the run, Cairo Santos set to kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And the Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out over the field. And last time the turnover on the fumble. And they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the
screen. We have no answers right now.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating.
I don't even answer you, except just third time Stevens.
That's good for a Pittsburgh Steeler.
Not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly.
That's caught inside the 20. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 27 yards on the game there. And it'll give them a fresh set of wins.
That's the end of the third quarter with the score spiking.
We need big plays soon. Not even big plays. We need touchdowns. We need a touchdown here. We need Tommy Stevens one-on-one with that stupid safety. Or Tommy Stevens left all alone by that stupid safety. All right, pending the extra point, we're all tied up. And we're down a touchdown. Tom Brady's X-Factor is activated.
All
right. We just need. In order for us to win this game, we need to stop here. And we need to feed Tommy Stevens the ball more. Now we just ran the same play, 3 plays in a row. Got completely open. Now he is our best player, best playmaker, best offensive player, best chance of winning.
At their own 34-yard line.
We just need, an interception. We just need that turnover. Try cover 3 here. They don't even deserve to be winning this game. We've given them this game.
That's good for a Viking. First down. First and 10 at the 37-yard line. Here we
go. All right, there we go. stop the run for the first time in 10 years. It's a run, it's a run. Can you not see that it's a run? Oh my. What is wrong with our defense? We truly have a defense full of idiots.
First and 10 at the 26 yard line.
Like we're gonna bring pressure here? And they're still gonna run right through us. Halfback wham. It's literally a run play. Interesting, really hurt. Of course. The game's over, just give them the trophy. It's over. We lose. Keep losing key players. Can't stop their run. They're just wasting time. They're going to kick a field goal. Put the game out of reach. Trubisky has literally just saved us. Three games in a row, he's an interception. I don't care about junior right now, Trubisky. We have more pressing matters. Cover two beater, Tommy Stevens, right up the gut. Make it happen. Wait. Yep. Oh, it's cover four. Same thing. Awesome. Oh, pass interference. All right, I don't think that's gonna work again. We gotta score a touchdown this drive. What are they doing? They're doing a cover three. All right, couple of yards. Third and four. Deep attack. It's a cover one. Cover one. Stevens could burn his man right here. And catch it. Like the legend that he is. Alright. Slot post. So they're running a cover three, so this is Perkins all the way. Yep, Perkins all the way. Alright, 17 yard gain right there. They're running a cover one. Cover one.
First and 10 at the 33 yard line.
Which means Etling on the shallow cross. That's just a bad play call. That's just a bad play call. I didn't know what I was calling. Double post. Gonna look Perkins here. So I think this is cover. Oh, he lost his X factor. I think this is a cover one. There you go, Mariota. Run for the first. So I'll no huddle this. We'll call this shallow cross. The shallow cross underneath RG3. First, now we're on the 8. Okay. This is where we have struggled all game long. Not done well inside the 10. I think it worked for us during the regular season. We try the struggler play. Get in there. Yes. Okay. We're tied up at 21. Assuming we have to make this kick. We have to make this kick and get a stop. Because their offense has been doing too well. They could score pretty quickly. Kick is up. Alright, tied at 21-21. Minute 56 left. Probably should have taken more time, but couldn't really be thinking about that. We're just looking to tie the game. Alright. Alright, so it's 30 yard line, they have 52. They just need a field goal. They just need a field goal. We're gonna try that cover one QB. We're gonna try that cover one contain. It worked last time. That's how we got the. That's how we got the pick in the last game. We'll just see what happens. Oh, that's incomplete. Alright, I think we should switch to a cover two man. So I don't think Burrow scrambled. I don't think it's in his coding or whatever. Alright, we're set on the rush. Let's see here. Okay, third and ten. This is good. This is very good. We can go cover one, contain. We got four men rushing and a QB spy. No. Wait, let him score. Okay. We have to score a touchdown. Quickly. We have a minute 30. After the kick, we have a minute 30. I should have called cover four. Story of the season. Okay. We just need to score. We should not even be thinking about the clock. We just need to score. And there's a block in the back row holds that pushes us back even further. So we're plugging to the 20-yard line, if that. Probably the 18. The 15. Alex McGo, you idiot. Okay, so. All right, we'll try Vert's shake. Stevens is one-on-one with his man. I think I'll take that. All right, hurry up. We're feeding it. If they're gonna keep calling, no, I called the wrong play. All right, they switch up their coverage. Oh, okay, that was almost really, really, really bad. Okay, we gotta stay five wide. I think we try Steelers cross. Stevens is not on a streak, so he should be able to find his way in between some coverages. Yep. Just catch it. Okay, no huddle. We're going same play. Steelers cross, same play. It's been working. It worked last time. Should work again. All right, Stevens. How does he know that's coming? You just turned into Houdini? Alright, we're gonna try Tommy Stevens. Steelers go. If this is a true cover two, this Tommy Stevens all the way. Tommy Stevens all the way. How do you not catch that? No. Since one of these safeties have 100 play rec? Okay, come on, Stevens. We call upon you in these dying hours. Take just as much time as possible off the clock and score. Right. So there's 21 seconds left. We should be able to hold off for 21 seconds. Okay. We should be able to hold off for 21 seconds. Any points. Even if they have three timeouts. We just gotta drop back, cover our man, and not make any idiotic mistakes. Take this into overtime. Hopefully we can get the ball. Get the ball. Go down, drive down the field. Score. Just like that. Alright, so there are 17 seconds left on the 25. We gotta be conservative, not too conservative. They're going in a... You guys want to take this into overtime? I'm down to go overtime. I mean, gives us a much better chance of anything good happening for us. Don't even show a kicker, they're not even trying. I mean, we have a 50-50 chance, essentially. Get the ball back, go down, drive down the field, and score. Oh, no, I don't like this. I mean, look, we're playing so well in this fourth quarter. We scored 21 unanswered points. Tails never fails. We would like to receive. You can give us whatever wins you want. We are driving down the field. We're going to score down your throats. This is...
If a defense scores, let's say the receiving team gets the ball.
Cairo Santos set to kick off.
Okay, so we know what we need to do. I think we just try to go that quick aggressive look again. I think we try to just feed Tommy Stevens down the field. I think we just try the Tommy Stevens special here. Hopefully it's all blitz. We can quickly get the ball in his hands. It's not. Catch the ball. Alright, we're going to go in the huddle. We are not slowing our tempo down. We've been in a rhythm all game long. We're just going to stick with it. Okay, I don't like this call. We're going to switch it to Steelers cross. Tommy Stevens. We're going no huddle. You're not letting them fix whatever is not working for them right now. Okay, I'm okay with that. No, I don't want to waste a play. I do not want to waste a play running the ball just for it not to work at all. We're going to change. We're going to change to the Tommy Stevens play here. Give me that Stevens special for a touchdown. Okay, he's inside the two. Now we run the ball. We give the ball to Amu up the gut. We pound the rock. Up the gut. We're going right at that X Factor. Let's go! We did it. We just won the Super Bowl. The greatest comeback I've ever done in Madden. We were down two touchdowns in the fourth quarter. They scored. We were down 21 points. No, we were only down 14. Yeah, we're down 14. Score two touchdowns, come back, tie the game. We let them score, we drive them down quickly down the field. Tails never fails, win the coin toss. Tommy Stevens, drive down the field, get us a touchdown. Definitely did not play it great. Tom Brady, two picks and a fumble in the red zone, mind you. This should have been an easy win, but we couldn't capitalize on our opportunities. Then we went to what makes this team great. Tom Brady to Tommy Stevens. Tommy Stevens, MVP of the series. I refuse to believe otherwise. If anybody can sit here, tell me to my face and change my mind, Tommy Stevens was not the MVP of this series. Change my mind. Literally, they were killing us. They were killing us in the beginning. First three quarters, that was all them. They were in complete control. Then, Tom Brady and Tommy Stevens showed up to play. We literally just made the best comeback. Look at player of the game. He had 334 yards on 15 receptions and two touchdowns. It does not get much better than this. We have just won the Super Bowl. This is a legendary Super Bowl. If this were to happen, 300 some yards in the Super Bowl, 334 yards in the Super Bowl. One singular wide receiver. Not even just a wide receiver group. That's remarkable in its own effect. But 334 yards from Tommy Stevens. He is the greatest player. He's the MVP of this series. And you cannot say otherwise. Literally, the turning point of the game was that Mitch Trubisky interception. I never thought I'd be saying that. But that Mitch Trubisky interception was the turning point of the Super Bowl. If Trubisky had not gotten that interception, I mean, chances are we're not here celebrating the Super Bowl win. Chances are the Vikings win the Super Bowl. I mean, there's no way. There's no way you can sit here and categorically tell me, and Tommy Stevens got a superstar. There's no way you can sit here and tell me that play does not, that play by Mitch Trubisky does not mean anything. I mean, look at this. I mean, we are 544 offensive yards, 523 passing yards, 23 first downs. We did it. We have won. The team's going to end up finishing at a 28 overall. This has been quite the journey, my friends. Let me tell you, I thoroughly enjoyed this. I hope you have all enjoyed this as well. This has been probably my favorite Madden save I've ever done. I really hope you all have enjoyed this this episode and everything that came with it. I mean, our team, we finished off as a pretty solid team. I mean, obviously not all these players, I don't know why the game signed some random players, but this team is electric. This team is a legendary team. We have finished as Super Bowl champions. We won the team. We won the Super Bowl. Alright, we should check out these yearly awards. My MVP went to Kyler Murray. I got Coach of the Year. Alright, let's check out the AFC. Offensive Player of the Year, Patrick Mahomes. It's questionable. Defensive Player of the Year. Remember our players are on our offensive rookie? Tommy Stevens. Of course. Ooh, Perkins is also up there. Strebler was on there. Hurts was on there. Best QB, yep. Best running back, best wide receiver. Tommy Stevens. So line. I really hope you all have enjoyed. I hope you all have enjoyed this series. This is the end. But I can't tell you this will not be the end of these position drafts. I will be doing one with every other group of positions. I hope you all have enjoyed this episode. Hope you subscribe to the channel. See more legendary moments like this. And it is Jay Beebs signing off.